Hello everybody. So I'm doing this video to talk to you guys about my weight loss journey from the beginning to the end. And clear things up, questions and things, you know, I want to be as transparent as possible and just help you guys, you know, answer all your questions and help you understand my journey and how hard it's been, but it's been worth it. Anyway, okay, so I have always struggled with my weight since I think the first time I really started gaining weight was when my father, you know, was removed from my life. I started using food to comfort me and I gained a lot of weight. So I went through all my preteens and teenage years overweight. And then when I was 18, my mom surprised me and took me to Mexico. And she said that I was gonna get my tonsils removed, but that was not the truth. She took me to a doctor and I had a weight loss surgery. So when I was 18, I had a weight loss surgery and I lost 60 pounds very, very fast. I went from 230 to 165 very fast, like in 4 months. I lost my hair, but I was really happy. But I lost so much weight and then I had a tummy tuck. So those are the two surgeries I've had ever. Weight loss surgery, gastric sleeve, which is basically they just cut half your stomach off. And then after that, since I lost weight so fast, my skin didn't have time to tighten up with me. So I got a tummy tuck right before I got married. And then got married. You know, then my mom passed away and I think that kind of added to my weight gain all over again. And then I think I had two kids after that and I gained everything I lost, I gained back in that time. So yeah, I think I stretched my stomach. It's very possible, you know, the way your skin stretches to fit everything in. So I stretched my stomach all over again and I think after I had Jordan, I realized, I was like, okay, I am back in the same size I was when I was 18. And I think I was 26 when I had Jordan, yes. And I was like, I can't believe this is me again. Like I gained all this weight back and I was very unhappy. More, obviously physically, I didn't feel comfortable. I still love myself, I'm still cute. You know, size 18 or size 10, I am still cute, but I wasn't happy. I wanted to have more energy for my kids. I wanted to be a good example to them. You know, how am I gonna tell my kids, make healthy choices and eat your vegetables if I wasn't being a living example for them? And I said, okay, no, I need to just change something about this. So as soon as I stopped breastfeeding, I was like, that's it, let's get on it. So I started my weight loss journey de nuevo, all over again, 2 years ago. And since then, I could say it was like around June 2016, I started my weight loss all over again, and this time I decided to do it all natural, like with healthy decisions and changing my habits. And as of June 2016 to now, I have lost, let's do the math, okay? Let's do the math. Give me 1 second. Okay, so 235 minus 166. I've lost 69 pounds, almost 70 pounds. Sometimes I go up and sometimes I go down on the scale. But yeah, so how did I begin? I started with just making small changes in my diet. No soda, no sugary drinks. I stopped eating hot Cheetos and like junk food. Sometimes I still have it from time to time. But in October of 2016, I started meal prepping and I've been doing meal prepping ever since. Meal prepping is amazing. I mean, each meal was like from 1,200 calories to 1,500 calories. That's pretty good for a woman. For guys, they need more than that, but for a woman of my age with not very much workout, that's how I lost all my weight very fast. I wasn't as dedicated in working out. I think the most I did was 3 workouts a week of 30 minutes. So a lot of my weight loss was of what I was eating, which is gonna be the same for everyone. your weight loss is going to be what you take in. The biggest challenges that I faced, I would mess up all the time. People might think, oh, in these 2 years, I never cheated my diet. It's not really a diet, it's a lifestyle change. So I'm obviously gonna have times where I mess up or I backslide, or a week where I don't wanna eat healthy, or a week where I don't work out. Those were my biggest challenges, was falling off the plan that I made with myself. But I think the most important thing in a weight loss journey is always getting back up. Most people want to say, oh, I'm going to start on Monday again. No, you start whenever you mess up. You know, you eat a bag of Hot Cheetos, or I don't know, holidays always mess people up. You get back on it. You know, like, it's not about depriving yourself of the things you like. It's, you know, I'm going to have a little bit, and you treat yourself for the 5 days that you had good, and then you get back on it. Don't let guilt hold you back. You know, so many people just like, I can't do it. I can't do it. No, you have to take I can't out of your vocabulary. It's I will do it. It's gonna take time, it's gonna take dedication, it's gonna take daily choices, but I'm gonna stick to it. It's like marrying your weight loss journey. You know, you might mess up, but you keep pushing. So I think that was one of my biggest challenges. And Hot Cheetos, those little, that bag of chips, I swear. I have them sometimes, you know, when I've done really, really good on Fridays. I count 28 chips and I put them in a bag, and that's my cheat. So, I mean, there's nothing wrong with having a cheat day. It's very, very, very necessary to make it through. But yes, it's when you mess up, not getting back up. I think that's where most people just like, I can't do it and I'm not going to do it anymore. No, the time is going to pass anyway. El tiempo va a pasar. What do you want to be doing in that time? Do you want to be bettering yourself little by little, or do you want to just give up and then see where you're at in a year, you know? So I just want to encourage you guys. It's not easy. It takes a lot. It takes a while. You know, 70 pounds in 2 years might not seem like a lot, but I'm really, really happy, and I don't even want to imagine where I would be in these 2 years if I didn't even decide to do it. So I just want to encourage you guys, whoever's wanting to start their weight loss journey, take little steps. Don't do a whole layout of what you need to do. It's little changes that you feel that you can commit to, and then once you see the progress in those changes, just keep pushing. And I want to encourage you guys, if you've been thinking about starting, just do it. You can do it. It might take time, but what I have seen, that things that take longer last longer. We can't have a You won't appreciate it as much if it happens overnight. You really won't. And you won't take care of it, because that's what happened the first time. I lost weight in 4 months and I gained it all back because it was, you know, easy. But, you know, now it's, I worked hard for it, and it's more like a trophy for me. So I encourage you guys to start and, you know, take little steps. You guys can do it. Give yourself a break when you mess up and get back on it. You're gonna learn a lot about yourself, and I just encourage you guys. I hope you guys like this video, and share it, subscribe, click on the little thingy, the little bell, so you guys can get my notifications, and share it with someone who's probably been struggling with the same thing that I have. You guys can do it. It's possible. If I can, you can. So, yeah, I like to. Oh, I would love to see your guys' feedback if you have started. Yeah. Okay. I love you guys. Bye.